In order for our bodies to remain in a balanced state and to respond to internal and external signals, we release varying amounts of hormones throughout the day. And one of those hormones is known as cortisol. And cortisol is released by a very specific gland called the adrenal gland that sits on top of the kidney. So we have two of them in our bodies. Now the adrenal glands release cortisol into the bloodstream, and typically that amount of cortisol increases during various times. And these times could be during stress, they could be during inflammation, or even during an immune response. However, cortisol levels are typically cyclic throughout the day. So in the morning, they're typically at their highest, and that's what gets us energized, gets us out of bed, and starts our day. Then they start to taper off throughout the day and into the evening, where they're at their lowest, and that kind of sends a signal to our bodies to begin to rest. But cortisol and the adrenal glands are also really important to interact with two other tissues that are found in the brain. And those are the hypothalamus and the anterior pituitary. And together, these form the HPA axis. So when cortisol levels in our blood are low, these tissues in our brain are able to sense it, and they send a start signal to the adrenal glands. And that tells the adrenal glands to release more cortisol. Then, as more cortisol is released into the blood, it's detected by those tissues in the brain, and they're able to turn off that start signal. So it's this constant feedback loop. And while it's important that cortisol levels are cyclic, we can have conditions where they can be too high or too low. When they're too high, this could be known as Cushing's syndrome, which has varying amounts of conditions, some of them being weight gain, easy bruising, as well as leg swelling. When the cortisol levels are too low, this could be known as Addison's disease, which is related to fatigue, muscle weakness, as well as mood changes. So that's why it's really important to ensure that all of our hormones, including cortisol, are balanced throughout the day in order for us to remain in a homeostatic state.